Can one person represent a whole community in the media? I think the word community itself is problematic, because what happens is the media is looking for a lot of media, I'm not saying everyone, but a lot of journalists are looking for one person to represent almost an entire community, to say this person knows what's going on. And I think that's a very problematic position to start from. People are individuals. There are lots of people who are different voices. And the problem is that certain groups come together and they say, hey, we're representing this community. And mostly they are male-dominated, they're middle-aged, and they're very conservative voices. So what happens is you hear from a very narrow section of society. And if we want to see people as individuals, if we want to see people from minority backgrounds as individuals with lots of different interests and, you know, see them as people as they normally are, then we have to get away from this idea of community. We have to get away from this idea that one person or a community group can represent a whole of them. Let people speak from a perspective. The Muslim Council of Britain, the Sikh Federation, the Hindu Forum, whatever, you know, they can claim this is what we think. But that should never be seen by the media as this person represents that voice, that community is not represented. That's a ridiculous proposition to start with, because we never have that for white community. You know, for the white community, it's a bit like saying the Catholic Church is going to now represent all white people in this country. That's basically what it comes down to, because these people don't have any democratic legitimacy for claiming to represent a community. And the problem is the media feeds into that. And as a result, you get a very narrow, very stereotypical view of people from those backgrounds. And I think that's dangerous and it's unhealthy.